This video is going to be about the universal set and set complements. So first, let's get an idea of what a universal set is. Let's say I've got a situation where I'm talking about the vowels in the English language, the letters A, E, I, O, and U. And all I'm going to be talking about is those vowels, nothing else. I can say that's the universe that I'm going to be talking about, and I'll call those letters my universal set. I'll designate the universal set usually with a capital U, and then I'm going to say that U equals the set containing A, E, I, O, and U. Now let's say I want a subset of this. Let's say I want a subset A, and subset A is going to consist only of the letters A and E. From this subset, I can create another subset, which I'm going to call the complement of A. The complement of A, which is going to be written as a capital A with a line over it, is going to be all of the letters in the universal set that are not in A. So the complement of A is going to be the letters I, O, and U. The complement of A is also a subset of U, and if I combined A and the complement of A, I would have all of the letters that are in the universal set. Here's another example. So here my universe is going to consist of the numbers 1, 2, 3, and up to 8. I can create the set A as maybe all of the even numbers, 2, 4, 6, and 8. And then if I want to talk about the odd numbers, all I have to do is call that the complement of A. If I want to fill in the set, it's going to be the numbers 1, 3, 5, and 7. Okay, so once again, the complement of A is all of the letters in my numbers in my universal set, which are not in set A. And one more example. So here my universe is going to consist of the colors red, blue, and green. I can say that let's have A consist of red, blue, and green. So A is not a proper subset of the universe, okay? But it is a subset. If I make the complement of A, then that's going to be an empty set. Okay, so the complement of A is all of the colors, all the elements in the universal set that are not in set A. But since set A is exactly the same as the universal set, there's nothing in the universal set which is not in set A, the complement of A is going to be an empty set. Okay, so that's basically what universal sets and complements of sets are about. Take care. I'll see you next time.